Hello, good day to you, and God bless you. I'm Pastor Josh, and you're watching the Fellowship of the Living Word. Today, I want to talk about the most famous verse in the entire Bible, that is John 3:16. John 3:16, what does it say? It says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Now, the reason why this verse is so popular, because it basically is saying that all you have to do is believe that Christ exists and you will be saved. Now, is that what it is actually saying? That all I have to do is believe and that I will be saved and have eternal life? And I can do whatever I want in my life? I can go on and sin? I can do whatever comes my way, I can basically be a bad person, a good person, I can be a moral person or immoral person. I can probably never pick up my Bible. Is that what it's saying? That all I have to do is believe? You know, I don't have to study, I don't have to pray, I don't have to do good works. All I have to do is believe. Is that what it's saying? Well, let's look a little deeper at this verse. Now it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever," that means anybody, "believeth." Now what's this word "believeth" come from? It's a Greek word, pisteo. And what it means is the original word, which is a much better explanation than what we have translated here in the English. This word pisteo in the Greek means to have faith, that is, credit, by implication to entrust, especially one's spiritual well-being to Christ. To put in trust with. This word, pisteo, means to trust. So, why is it translated believe? Well, I don't know. I have to ask the translators of the King James why they chose to put the word believe rather than the word to trust or entrust. But that's the translation that we have. And many of the other translations that you have are based on this translation. So, you know, this verse is misunderstood. So the word believeth comes from the word pisteo, meaning to trust. Now, this is in Scripture where we can see that, yeah. Well, let's go to James. James chapter 2, verse 18 through 20. And verse 18 says, "Yea, a man may say that thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me thy faith without thy works, and I will show thee my faith by my works." 19, "Thou believest." That's the word right there, pisteo. "Thou believest that there is one God. Thou doest well. The devils also believe and tremble. But will thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead?" So this word pisteo, when it's properly translated, says something quite different than what we have here in the King James Version. Okay? So, thou pisteo, right, in verse 19, "thou believest, thou pisteo, that there is one God." Okay, it's saying, you trust that there is one God. You do well. And what does it say? The devils also believe and tremble. Do you think Satan believes Jesus exists? Yeah. Do you think Satan believes that Jesus died on the cross for the sins of mankind? Yes. Do you think Satan knows that Jesus is going to be resurrected and he's going to come and return for the second advent and take his people with him? Yes. Do you think that Satan knows that we're in the time of the investigative judgment and that he has a last days church? Yes, he believes in all these things. He knows, because he knows Scripture. He knows the Word. He's very familiar with it. He also knows Jesus personally. They were at one time best friends. Okay? And Satan fell. And Satan knows that he exists. He had a personal relationship with him. He was cast out of heaven by him. He's at war with him. The fallen angels know who Jesus is as well. They once worshipped him. They no longer do, but they definitely believe. Even demons, when they possess human beings, they have to obey Jesus because they know him. They believe him. It says in the Bible that one day every knee shall bow. Does that mean believe? Does that mean that every knee that is bowing is going to be saved? No. Okay? So there's more to it. You have to have a working faith in order to be saved. Let's be very clear here. According to Ephesians 2:8, for grace, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Verse 9, not of works, lest any man should boast. It is only through the blood of Jesus Christ that we are saved. It's by grace, through faith, a working faith.